So this is the next class of our progressions, as we already discussed about the progressions. And then in that, what is arithmetic progression? So just recall what is arithmetic progression. The terms in arithmetic progression are a1, a2, a3, an. Here I told you already a1 is first term, and d is called common difference. Common difference means difference between any two successive terms is equal, then that is called as common difference. The name itself tells you that it is common with the difference. So it can be a2 minus a1, a3 minus a2, and so on, an minus an minus 1. Here an equals to nth term. So this is the last term. If a progression contains only n terms, that is a finite arithmetic progression. If it contains infinite terms, that is called as infinite arithmetic terms. So here our arithmetic progression consists of only n terms. So that is called as finite arithmetic progression, where an is called as the nth term. And also it is called as last term, and also it is called as general term. And I told you how did we get that an equals to a plus n minus 1 into d also. So this is the general format of nth term, is an equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. So till now we discussed in the previous class, children. Now let us move on some sums based on this formula and arithmetic progression. So once it is clear, you please try to do by your own that exercise 6.1. So first sum, 4, 10, 16, 22. These are the terms in arithmetic progression. Find the 10th term. So generally, you have to check that whether it is an AP or not. No need to check. Actually, it is given already AP. So check out what is A1 here. First term, 4. Difference means difference between any two successive terms, like second term minus first term, third term minus second term, like that. So 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. And then which term they asked to find? 10th term. So 10th term is nothing but n equals to 10. So now question is a10 formula you have to find out. An equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. So a plus n minus 1 into d means here a10. A plus 9d, because 10 minus 1 equals to 9d. Now a value is 4, d value we got it already 6, then 9 6 is 54. 54 plus 4, 58. So this is 10th term of this given arithmetic progression. Just simply remember the formula and substitute those values in the formula. Second one. This second one, the question is given to you that you form an AP. That means you are supposed to prepare an AP where an equals to given as 5 plus 4n. And n belongs to n. That means n is a natural number. So and when it is given as n belongs to n, that means n value will be 1, 2, 3 and so on. And also given that an equals to 5 plus 4n. That means if n value is 1, you have to substitute the n value is 1 here. So if n is equals to 1, what will you get here? A1 will get. That means first term will get 5 plus 4 into 1. 5 plus 4 equals how much? 9. Because 4 into 1 is 4. That's the same way n equals to 2. A2 equals to 5 plus 4 into 2. 5 plus 4 2 is 8. That is nothing but 13. Now A3. 5 plus 4 into 3. 4 3 is 12. 5 plus 12 17. So now we got terms like 9, 13, 17. Actually, it is automatically it is AP only. But just check out whether it is AP or not. Observe the second term minus first term. 13 minus 9, 4. And third term minus second term, 17 minus 13, again 4. That means we got same difference. That means it's common difference. Both are equal. So it forms an AP. The terms are 9, 13, 17, and so on. So you no need to write the last term, because the question is they asked to find the AP. So that is sufficient. You may get the 9, 13, 17, and so on are in AP. Next, children, find D. When an equals to 3n minus 2, n belongs to n, n in AP. Again, same model only. In this case, the question is not form AP. It is asked to find the common difference D. See, how do you will get the D? The difference between any two successive terms. That means you should get the any two terms. Like whether it is given an equals 3n minus 2, you find a10 and a11. Otherwise, a100 and a101. Any two successive terms you find out. And difference between the two successive terms, that means higher term minus lower term, automatically will get the common difference. So here what I did is n equals to 1 I took, and n equals 2 I took, and a1 equals to 3 into 1, 3 minus 2, 3 minus 2 is how much? 1. And a2 equals to 3 into 2, 6 minus 2, 4. So that means we got first term and second term. Find out the subtraction, 4 minus 1 equals how much? It is 3. So like this you can find out the common difference. Both questions are same only. Previous question they asked to find the AP. In this question they asked to find the common difference. Now fourth question. Which term of the AP 3, 8, 13, 18 and so on is 78? And given terms are in AP only. Now which term of this AP is 78? That means which number of the term, like this is first term is 3, second term is 8, third term is 13, fourth term is 18. Like that, what is the term is 78? So that number, that means n value you are supposed to find. So observe here, given AP is 3, 8, 13 and 18. That means here a1 equals to a, that means 3. And common difference is a2 minus a1, 8 minus 3 equals to 5. And nth term is given as an equals 78, because already is given as which term, that means general term. This is a 70 some term is nothing but general term. So nth term I wrote it as, what is the formula of nth term here? A plus n minus 1 into d equals to 78. A value is how much? 3. N value only we don't know, so leave it as n minus 1. D already we found, no, it is 5. So n minus 1 into 5 equals to 78. Now this is an equation. From this equation you are supposed to find the n value. So first 3 this side, left side, send to the right side. So what it becomes here, when it is in plus symbol, when it comes to the right side it becomes minus. 78 minus 3 equals to 75. Now n minus 1 into 5 equals to 75. Now n minus 1 into 5, no, again send this 5 that side, it transpose to division, 75 by 5. 75 by 5 means how much? 15. Now again this minus 1 is there, no? That minus 1 again transferred to right side. So n equals to 15 plus 1. So how much we got? N equals to 16. So 16th term of this AP is 78. Because finding which term, that means you are supposed to find the n value. So here I underline the observe here. 16th term of the given AP equals to 78. So these are some basic terms, basic problems of arithmetic progression, which completely deals with the nth term. So based on this you can do the exercise also. Now what I did is 6.1 exercise, I'm giving you one or two sums explanation and other sums you please do by your own. Like that, if you take the first sum, write any four terms of the AP when a equals to minus 2 and d equals to 0. So as you all know that when a equals to minus 2, that means first term is minus 2, a1 equals to a minus 2, and a2 nothing but first term plus common difference, a1 plus d. a1 is nothing but a, d is 0, so minus 2 plus 0. Again, how much we got here? Minus 2 only we got. Now a3 means a plus 2d. Our formula is an equals a plus n minus 1 into d, n minus 1 in the sense less 1 less than the n. So a3, no, 1 less than 3, 2. So a plus 2d. A value how much? Minus 2 plus 2 into d. D is 0. Minus 2 plus 0 equals to minus 2. Now a4. A4 is nothing but a plus 3d. Minus 2 plus 3 into 0. So minus 2 plus 0. Again minus 2. So we got when d is 0, all terms are same only we are getting. First term also minus 2, second term also minus 2, third term also minus 2, fourth term also minus 2. Because d is 0. In previous class I told you common difference can be positive, can be negative, can be zero also. So the reason we got when the d equals zero, all terms are equal. Let us observe one more example. Same thing, four terms of AP where a value is given, d value is minus 0.25 is given. See, a negative decimal point. That means the common difference is a real number, can be a rational, can be irrational also, no problem. Now a1 equals to a minus 1.25, it is given in first term, done first term. Now second term, a2. What the formula for a2? A plus d. 1 minute. Now observe the second term. a2 equals to a plus d. A plus d in the sense, a equals to minus 1.25 plus d is nothing but minus 0.25. Both are negative numbers and adding. As I told you already, if both are negative numbers and having addition symbol, means again you have to add the terms and keep the minus symbol. Minus 1.25 plus 0.25. So adding and minus symbol I kept. So by adding, how much you are getting now? Minus 1.5.
50. 1.50 nothing but minus 1.5 only. Now third term, A3, A plus 2D. A value is minus 1.5. D is nothing but minus 0.25 into 2. Minus 0.25 into 2 is minus 0.50. Minus 1.25 plus minus 50 is nothing but minus 1.75, because both are negative numbers adding. Now you can understand easily that, sir, are we supposed to do like this, or we can add the D to the previous term? You can add D to the previous term. Minus 1.5 plus 0.25, minus 1.75 only will come. Again, for this, if you add 0.25, it becomes minus 2. So, however, either you can apply this formula or adding D to the previous term also, you will get the next term. Because the question is to find out any four terms. So, I applied by using the nth term formula. Or you can directly adding to the common difference to the previous term, you will get the second term. Both the methods are correct. Now, for following APs, this is another model. Find A and find D. Find A and find D in a sense, what is the first term and what is the common difference. Here the AP is given as minus 5, minus 1, 3, 7. That means first term is how much? Minus 5. Common difference means second term minus first term, or third term minus second term, or fourth term minus third term. Fourth term minus, both are positive symbol, you can apply the differences, no problem. 7 minus 3, how much you should get? 4. No, sir, I want to take second term as first term. You can take second term as first term also. Second term is minus 1, minus of, first term is minus 5. Here, minus of minus becomes plus 5. Minus 1 plus 5 becomes 4. So, anyway, it comes as D only same. So, the other model, 1/3, 5/3, 9/3, 13/3. Again, first term, 1/3. Common difference, A2 minus A1. 5/3 minus 1/3. 5/3 minus 1/3, how much here? 5 minus 1/3. Equals to 4/3, because like fractions we can add up. So you check out, children, this is 0.6 A value, and common difference means 1.7 minus 0.6. So subtract it, check out that you will get 1.1 only. This is the third model. Fourth model, children, what is the fourth model? Tells you that in this fourth model only we have more sums are there, like nearly 10 to 12 sums are there. So I explained you 6 sums. The remaining sums you please do by your own, children. Which of the following are AP? That means there are given a sequence of numbers. That means a list of numbers are given. And you have to check that whether they form AP or not. How to check whether they form AP or not? Just only the difference is common for the two successive terms. Then it is in AP. Otherwise it is not in AP. That is the method. Now question is, if those are in AP, find the common difference and also find that three more terms in the given AP. Here if you take that here, so first progression, first numbers are 2, 4, 8, 16. So check out that A2 minus A1. How much you get now? 4 minus 2, 2. Third one is A3 minus A2. 8 minus 4 equals to 4. See that here. Common difference is not same. So, the given numbers doesn't form an AP. Now, second question. 3, 3 plus root 2, 3 plus 2 root 2, and 3 plus 3 root 2. Again, you have to check out here, second term minus first term. 3 plus root 2 minus 3. 3 get cancelled, root 2 is the answer. Now A3 minus A2. A3 is 3 plus 2 root 2 minus 3 plus root 2. Here minus, remove minus symbol. The brackets when you remove, both will get the negative symbol. So 3 plus 2 root 2 minus 3 minus root 2. Minus root 2 nothing but it is, see, 2 root 2 is 2 into root 2. Root 2 nothing but 1 into root 2. So this 3 will get cancelled. So finally what is left over? 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2. 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2 means 1 root 2 only. 1 root 2 nothing but again root 2. So here root 2 we got, here root 2 we got. That means difference is same. So, when the difference is same, the number forms an AP. Question is, what is the common difference? That is only, the root 2 is only the common difference. Now, question observe here. First term, second term, third term, fourth term. So, what will the next term? Fifth term. So, that's the reason I found A5. A5 equals to A plus 4D. A value is how much? 3 plus 4 into D value how much? Root 2. 3 plus 4 root 2. Easily you can guess it here. 3 plus 1 root 2, 3 plus 2 root 2, 3 plus 3 root 2, 3 plus 4 root 2. The next term will be 3 plus 5 root 2, 3 plus 6 root 2. Easily you can write the next terms when like adding root 2 to the previous term. Third question, Amma. Hope understand, children. I'm going very slowly. Just listen very carefully. Then you will get a clear idea about this exercise. Very easy exercise. A2 minus A1. A square minus A.
because first term is a, second term is a square. So a square minus a, a square minus a cannot be simplified further. Only you can take common. And a3 minus a2, a cube minus a square. Again, this cannot be again subtracted. So those two terms are not equal, no? So that reason, this number do not form AP. Now, fourth question, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, and so on. So already we did one sum, 2, 2, 2, 2. That is automatically is given AP, that is common difference 0. When the terms are like same terms, the common difference is 0, then the terms are AP only. Next terms also what will get here, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2 only will come. See, this is the process, I am not going to explain you. See, a2 minus a1 I found, a3 minus a2 I found, I got a5 I found, check out. So you please have a look once and try to understand that how I found a5, a6, a7. As I told you already minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2 and so on, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. Next question, children, very important question, that it all every time is given for 2 marks. This question, root 2 comma root 8 comma root 18 comma root 32. So a2, by seeing like this one we can feel that as it is not AP, but check out that whether it is possible or not. A2 minus a1, root 8 minus root 2, root of 4 into 2, root of 4 into 2, in the sense it is root 4 into root 2, amma. root 4 nothing but 2. 2 cannot be having square root, no? So let it be 2 root 2. So what I'm trying to do is 8, I'm writing it as a product of one perfect square and then a normal number. So it is 4 into 2. 4 is perfect square. Perfect square in the sense, if a number can be expressed as a product of two equal numbers, then it is called as perfect square. 4 can be written as 2 into 2. 9 can be written as 3 into 3. 16 can be written as 4 into 4, like that. So those are called as perfect squares. Now root 8, 4 into 2. 4 can be out means 2 will come. 2 root 2, it is 1 root 2. 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2, like thirds. These are called as like thirds. 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2 equals 1 root 2. 1 root 2 nothing but root 2. Now we'll find out the third term minus second term. Third term is how much? Root 18. Root 18 minus root 8. Root 18 nothing but 9 twos are, because perfect square into the 3 6 also you can write, but we don't have any requirement. Perfect square I am writing, so 9 twos I am writing. 9 into 2, 9 can be written as 3 into root 2. Already root 8 we found it as 2 root 2 in the previous a2 minus a1. So 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2 equals 1 root 2. Again it is also root 2. See, in this case both root 2s are equal, so it is common difference same. So the number forms an AP, and a common difference equals to root 2 only. Now the question is, what is the next term? Observe very careful, children. First one is 1 root 2, second one is 2 root 2 because root 8. Third one is 3 root 2. Fourth one automatically 4 root 2 only will come. Next, fifth one will be 5 root 2, 6 root 2, 7 root 2 only will come. But we'll check out whether it is coming or not. A5, A plus 4D. A value is how much? Root 2. Plus D value how much? Root 2. Again, this is root 2, 4 into root 2. 1 root 2 plus 4 root 2. 5 root 2. 5 will go inside means 5 square. 5 square into 2, 25 into 2, 50. Either you can leave it as 5 root 2 or you can keep it as root 50. See, observe that in the previously, when 4 is inside, when it comes outside, it becomes 2. In the same way, when something is outside, when you want to send into root, it becomes square and then sent into the root, because root 5 square becomes 5. The process is going on like this one. Next will be 6 root 2. Next will be 7 root 2. Same process. 5 root 2, 6 root 2, 7 root 2, 8 root 2, like this will come. 6 goes inside means 36, because 6 is square. 36 into 2, 72. The same way, 7 root 2. 7 goes inside means 7 square into 2. 49 into 2, 98. Like this. The same way, next will be 8 root 2. 8 will go inside means 64 into 2. 64 into 2 is 128. Like this, next will be root 120. Like this, you can write how many times if you want, like that. This is very important. Check out very. So easy sum also. Now, 6 one. Same model roots only. Root 3 comma, root 6 comma, root 9 comma, root 12. Second term minus first term, root 6 minus root 3. See, root 6 cannot be written as any product of perfect square and a number, 3 into 2. 3 cannot come outside, 2 cannot come outside. So we can't do further simplification. The reason I left like this only, like root 6 minus root 3 only. Because thirds cannot be subtracted so easily and added so easily. Unless those are like thirds. Now a3 minus a2, root 9 minus root 6. Root 9 is nothing but 3. 3 minus root 6. So the above one is root 6 minus root 3, below one is 3 minus root 6. Both are not same, so the numbers do not form AB. So children, I almost covered the difficulty sums in that exercise. The easy sums I'm giving you as a homework. You complete those sums as homework, submit in WhatsApp group. So I made this video for the children who missed the class in Zoom. So you please listen this class once again to do the problems. Having any queries, you please ping me in WhatsApp. I will explain you all the sums once again, whatever you heard out. Children, please follow this chapter. So easy chapter, don't leave it. Okay, no? Thank you, children. Have a good day. Bye.